anything. Yeah. And they're, you know, we know it. Because they can't dance to the pocket. As they filter through, you get a pocket. So,
So
like you said, like how you took that saying, he who put someone in captivity shall be in captivity. Like, everyone that has an ear interprets things differently. So God, I'm sure he wasn't a person that could just write down stuff, like write down stuff.
Well, he had.
This is book of 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 21. It says, the first Peter chapter.
The first Peter. What is it? I'll look it up.
I just saw it. 2 Peter, I think 2 Peter 1. Yeah, yeah. So, this is 2 Peter 1, verse 20. It says, knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. So just like you said a minute ago, you know, a person might take the Bible and interpret it the way he wants it. Just because he interprets it that way don't mean he's right. There's only one truth of it. You know, there's only one true interpretation. So he can go, this white man does that all day. That's why they're running around saying that Jesus is white right now. Even though when you read what Jesus looks like, it tells in the Bible, he was a dark-skinned man with woolly hair. You know what I'm saying? So there's no way that they can read the description of Jesus Christ and come out with this interpretation right now. But they do it anyway. But even though they do it, it doesn't mean it's true. You know what I'm saying? It's only one truth. So it says, for the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man. You know what I'm saying? Because this book wasn't put together because some men wanted to put together. That's what I'm saying. He said, but holy men of God spoke as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. You know what I'm saying? The Lord is a king. Just like if you were a king, you would have servants. You wouldn't do nothing. You simply would go do whatever you want. The Lord is the same way. He put the earth. The Lord created the earth, but he really had Jesus and the angels go put it together. But he But that's a little deeper, you know what I'm saying?
And let me just get this for you. This is Psalm 68:11. The Lord gave the word. He gave the word, okay? He gave, but he gave it unto his servants, the prophets,
right?
Great was the company of those that published it, okay? So the ones that published his word, like Moses, who else? Obadiah, all these different prophets that the Lord authorized them to do. Now the King James Version,
the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit, when you deal with the Holy Spirit, it's just the Spirit the Lord puts on you to understand and give you gifts to do certain things. You know, it's not the same thing like church.
This is the book of 2 Ezra chapter 15, verse 1. It says, behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy, which is the scripture. It says, which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord, and cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true. So these are his words. He said, I'm going to cause these things to be written in paper. And here they are. But these are his words. So these ain't nothing that we just came up and made up on our own. You know what I'm saying? And plus, like you said, I came declaring the end from the very, very beginning. Only a supernatural being can do something like that. There's no way, but there's no technology, no nothing that somebody can tell us that shit like this is going to happen. How could somebody possibly do that? How could they even say a number? There's going to be a number of a man. His name is going to be 666. We make predictions. There's going to be an earthquake on May 21st. You know what I'm saying? The world's going to end May 21st. We don't say there's going to be a number of a man. And that don't even make sense. But today, we see that boy walking across the street with a shirt with a 666 shirt on. You know what I'm saying? Did you see that? The goat shirt? So, how else could they do that?
The Bible, the number
13. This is a flyer. You're talking about how we learn about this. We got a YouTube page on the internet. Arsets does. Arsets, we got a this is our main page. We got a home page. This one right here. And actually, it tells you about Quasimodo. That's that Quasimodo.
Put the fire within
likely. Most likely you are, you know what I'm saying, because you're spirit. We also go by the spirit, you know what I'm saying? And because you can say like, oh,
their spirit is going to rise up. It's not so much a flesh and blood, it's a spirit.
Right.
So you tell a white man he's going to slavery, that ain't something that he wants to hear. So he's not using his say here, or he's going to argue with you, talk about your shit, you know what I'm saying? He's not going to really have a good public conversation. So, you know, that's how we try to spirit also.
Right.
But, I mean, sometimes our people, dark skin, black people, don't care to argue about it, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know?
Yeah, but like, that's kind of... Like if you were to come here like, oh, I can hire some Mexicans to be slaves, I'm gonna be like, oh,
exactly.
I'm curious.
I mean, I understand it. When you come from South Africa, you're gonna be slaves. I might not sit there and talk with you. I might laugh and keep it moving, you know what I'm saying? It's reality. We already been slaves before, you know what I'm saying? You know, but then there's people who look like you telling this. They'll sit here with you and talk with you for a while. You know, on their father's side, they're Irish, or, you know, or Native American Indian or something like that. You know what I'm saying? It's like, wow, you gotta go spend all the time.
Right.
But, you know,
I want to say something. Just because you say the records. They Spanish mixed in with a whole plethora of different people. So really the only way you know really tell is your spirit is not it's someone of the 12 tribes.
Yeah, you said you listen to the scriptures and you said, well, we're gonna go for one of our more. What did Jesus say? He said, my sheep hear my voice. Right. So these words just came out, they're resonating inside. Like I said, this is a spiritual thing, you know what I'm saying? So if the resident takes the sign with you, then the Lord must be dealing with you.
Yeah, dealing with you, I understand.
Because believe it or not, I mean, you're saying you were walking up down the street right now. You don't care about this, you know what I'm saying? So if one person walks up, it's like, Lord, you must have guided this man over. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
For real.
I mean, I think everybody should be like, okay, where did we come from? Where? Sure.
The Lord didn't give everybody the understanding of the mind that you could think that, you know what I'm saying? But you didn't. You're not dealing with everybody on the planet Earth. So this is showing that the Lord is perfect, and he's so perfect he has to be able to remember who he's going to come to get. You know what I'm saying? He's saying who's going to save and who's not going to save. This is the book of Zechariah chapter 13, I'll start the 8th verse. It says, and it shall come to pass that all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die.
Right, two parts shall be cut off and die. Okay, so the Lord, so you gotta imagine, our people, they say, the scripture says that our people are the sand of the sea. So there's a lot of large part of our people that's in the planet Earth. But two-thirds of that people is gonna be destroyed. Okay? You gotta think how...
That's what's coming.
Yeah, that's what's coming. That's a large number of our people. That's why a large number of our people... You see, a lot of black Hispanics, they're walking by. Black people, Native Americans, walking by.
It's the Israelites
there. Yeah, they're Israelites, but they're walking by, and they're not getting this word. The majority of them, it's not for them, and they're going to be destroyed.
What you have to understand is, when you read the Bible, from the time the Israelites were slaves in Egypt, and then God sent Moses to go and get them, and he went to the wilderness, and he gave them the laws, the statutes, and commandments. From that time, the Israelites were breaking the laws over and over and over again. A lot of punishment the Lord was telling them in the slavery, you know what I'm saying? America's not the first slavery that we've been in. We've been slavery over and over and over.
Okay.
Now that after America is destroyed, the next kingdom that's coming next, according to the Bible, is the kingdom of heaven. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So the Lord don't got time to play the slavery game. You know what I'm saying? It's over. You know what I'm saying? All of our enemies just read, the punishment of our iniquity is accomplished. So I will no more carry you away to come in. So we're not going to slavery no more. So what he's going to do this time? Because all of our people who won't get right, two-thirds of them is going to get. You know what I'm saying? He's going to save one-third. He's going to save one-third of our people. He's going to kill two-thirds of them. And then the one-third, he's going to save them. Jesus comes back with the angels, and he's going to take them back into the land of Israel.
If you really believe that, then one-third, we've got to be the kingdom of heaven.
The kingdom of heaven is going to be on earth. That's what we're saying. It's not a place up in the sky, up there where people are thinking. Now, there is the heavens up there. The Lord's in the heavens.
Yeah.
But you know?
Yeah, there's multiple heavens. There's the heaven down here. There's heavens up in the sky, but the heavens in space, but in the spiritual.
Right.
That's where the Lord is. It actually speaks to that in the scriptures. the third heaven.
Have you ever heard of the Lord's Prayer? Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And it says, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. You know what I'm saying? So the kingdom of heaven is going to be on earth. We're going to have kids today. We're going to have more and more kids. You know, the sex is still going to be happening in the kingdom of heaven.
Right.
The Lord says that he's going to put us back in our land, and we're going to be fruitful and we're going to multiply. But the same way the white man, Donald Trump, puts his finger on anything in terms of gold, it's going to be like that for us, the kingdom of heaven. Nothing we do is going to go wrong. All the blessings that, remember when I read, the Lord said he's going to put us above all nations if we keep his commandments? After that, it tells you all the blessings that we're going to come. You know what I'm saying? That's what's going to happen to us in the kingdom of heaven. Over and over and over again. So we're going to be a nation full of kings and priests. And our children are going to prophesy. We're not going to have to teach each other the laws of the Lord. Because the Lord said they're going to put the laws in our hearts. And we're not going to even sin no more. We're not going to break the laws no more. So we're never going to throw us in the captivity again.
Let's finish that part.
Yeah. So, I'm sorry, I'm gonna start over again. This is Zechariah 13:8. It says, and it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die.
Third part.
It says, but the third shall be left therein. It says, and I will bring the third part through the fire.
Yeah, he's gonna bring the third part, the one third of our people that's gonna make it up out of here, that's gonna be saved. He's gonna bring them through the fire, through that trial, through that tribulation. That's going to happen soon in the coming days.
It says, I will bring them through the fire and will refine them. Silver is refined.
Right.
I will try them as gold is tried.
Oh, I see. Because to be saved, you got to have, be elect.
Right.
All right. So, and that's talking about one third, a small number of people that's going to come back to the knowledge, accept this truth.
Okay. It says, try them as gold is tried. They shall call on my name.
They shall call on his name.
And I will hear them. I will say it on my people. And they shall say the Lord, my God.
Right, so they're going to, the remnant of our people is going to know his name. They're going to call upon him. They're going to be saved by him through Christ's name when they come back. Okay? And knowing that name is very important.
This is why we know the Bible is true, because it tells you what happens before it happens.
Right.
You know, you go to a movie with somebody. It's your first time seeing a movie, but he's telling you what's going to happen. You'll be upset about it. Hold on, now let me see the movie.
Right.
But in this movie, the Lord has told us, he's given us a script, so we know exactly what's going to happen.
Right.
We know that when America is destroyed, the Chinese is not going to rule next.
Right.
We know that because of what the Bible is saying to us. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
What did you want me to get?
Get us, what's the second? That's what's 13.
Yeah.
I guess.
I want to show something to go with this too. Right after we read this. I'm sure that this white man knows that this is true. He knows how accurate this Bible is, and he's going to further prove that he's a devil, because he knows this is true, but he puts out all kinds of other philosophies to keep you understanding what's going on. And we don't realize that, most people don't, that it is a white man's world. He's in control of the laws that are passed on the ground. You know what I'm saying? He can make the laws in the Bible relevant. He can do it. Instead, he goes in the Bible and finds out what God says not to do, and then he makes laws and says it's okay to do. Like two men getting married. He goes in the Bible and says that men aren't supposed to be with men, but he goes it. But at the same time, as he passes laws saying it's okay, he holds the Bible and acts like he's a Christian. You know what I'm saying? That is the devil and the deceiver. You know what I'm saying? He's got the whole world to think. Along with that picture right there. That is a lie right there. You know what I'm saying?
And also, too, I mean, shit, you know, we're not like in the land of Israel, when we was an established nation, the men were supposed to go out to war when they're age 20. In this current empire that we're living in America, is age 18. So it's going contrary to what the scriptures say.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, and there's many different examples of that.
Really? The Bible says not to play with animals. This guy went and made a law saying bestiality is legal. Who does that? You know what I'm saying? But what did God say? He said, consider the words of the Lord. How can you make straight that which I made to be crooked?
Right.
He made the white man to be crooked, because he did. That's what he did. That was his purpose on the planet, to do what he's doing right now. If he made him to be like this, there ain't nothing we can do the same. You know what I'm saying? Nothing. He's going to continue to get more and more and more and more work.
Right.
And the cool part is he's able to do all of these different things on planet Earth and still make us question whether or not he's the devil. But he's been doing this shit the whole time. If you can tell me one good thing, this man's rise to America, I'll stop talking. But nobody can. He hasn't done anything good except for bring death and destruction wherever he went. If he tells you there's a Caucasian, that means he's telling you came out of the Caucasus Mountains. So if you're in the Caucasus Mountains, how are you in Russia right now? How are you all over the world?
Where's that Caucasus Mountains?
It's in Russia.
Georgia,
Russia. So if you guys go over there, how are you all over the world? God didn't give you these lands. You came out and you stole them. But isn't that what the Bible said that the devil was going to do? Said he was going to weaken the nations. Said he goes to and fro, seeking to destroy that which is not his. Or roughly paraphrasing, something like that.
And the main land that he's stolen is all these, the land that we're living in right now. You know what I'm saying? Stole it from the Native American Indians. He stole your land, you know what I'm saying? And to call y'all as illegal immigrants like we brought out before. You know what I'm saying? And you know, this scripture, but going all the way back before that this happened, this scripture is gonna tell you what where you guys will be at.
The way Mexico is set up now, we take our oil, the Mexicans take our oil and send it to the US, and the US sells it back to Mexico. And that's how it is right now.
But see that goes back. But that's the point. But remember we were reading about the servant and tribute? That's y'all. You're gonna work for that oil, you're gonna give it back to him, and he's gonna give it, sell it back to you. You just work.
Yeah, remember we were just reading that thing about Issachar? We were breaking down the crap between two burdens. We can read it again, you wanna hear it again.
Yeah, servant, it became a servant and tribute. Yeah.
So these prophecies are hitting with pinpoint accuracy. They don't fit everybody. There's no way that the Russians can come and say that that's talking about them. If it fit, we would say it. You know what I'm saying? It just doesn't. You know what I'm saying? This is the truth of the matter. Hold on.
48.
Oh, here
we go.
It says, I'll start here. This is Genesis 49, chapter 14, verse. It says, Issachar is a strong ass couching down between two burdens. And he saw that the rest was good, and the land that it was pleasant, and bowed his shoulder to bear, and became a servant and a tribute.
Bowed his shoulders to bear, and became a servant and a tribute. And that's exactly what's happened. Because even during that time when they conquered y'all, they made you guys go into your own gold and silver mine, and work for them, and dig up all that stuff that you guys had. You know what I'm saying? But the same thing's going on. The same thing's happening. Because like the scripture says, no new thing has been under the sun. So the same thing's happening today. Like you just testified, like you guys is digging up that oil, just giving it to them, and they're selling it back.
That's how you know that it's the right thing that stands to rule the world.
I think a lot of what's going on in Mexico, I personally think, has a lot to do with the United States. Because how does the United States benefit? Imagine having three powerful nations here in one continent. Having Canada strong, United States, Mexico, both different colors. Imagine that. Yeah. Mexicans don't agree with everything in the United States. They're raised different. People are out born and poor. Gonna have different president, different mindset. Not one that was born into being president, one that was probably, you know,
poverty.
Yeah, and that's right.
That's not happening now.
And now, even though that you guys have make up a large population of Mexico, the strainers are the main people that are running your government. You know what I'm saying? So that's why, you know, wherever you go with Mexico, you know what I'm saying, you guys are gonna be a popular. And that's part of the curse. You know, all our people would be impoverished wherever they be at. You know, they'd be the bottom of the barrel, so to speak. But let's get
this. This is seeking to prove this wiping of the floor. This is 2 Ezra chapter 13. 13 to 40. It says, those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Salmanazar, the king of Assyria, led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, and so they came into another land.
Right, so during the time of Israel, we had a civil war in Israel. That's why you see the northern kingdom and you see the southern kingdom. No different today. It's basically Hispanics versus black. Okay, back during those times. And our nation was separate. Okay, and it said the 10 tribes. The 10 tribes is Simeon all the way down to Issachar. Okay, the Lydian tribes, the Hispanics and Native American Indians. Okay, now they were the Babylonians had the southern kingdom in slavery, and Assyria had the 10 tribes in slavery. This was its own interest.
So it says It says, but they took counsel among themselves. Talking about the 12 tribes took counsel among themselves. It says that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt.
Right, so they took counsel among themselves and keep these steps, lost their commandments, and go to a further country where never mankind dwelt. Right? Now that same land is speaking of over here. I mean, it's gonna explain it.
It says that they might keep their statues, which they never kept in their own land.
Right, because during that time, during the Civil War, particularly the Northern Kingdom, they were going off in the idolatry. They were doing things that were contrary to the law. Okay, so they want
Northern
Kingdom. Yeah.
It says, and they entered into the Euphrates by the narrow passages of the river.
Right, they entered in the narrow passage of the Euphrates rivers when they left and they were escaping Babylon and Syria. They were going through that narrow passage, right, all the way down to the point of Africa.
It says, for the Most High then showed signs for them and held still the flood till they were passed over. It says, for through their country there was a great way to go, namely a year and a half.
Right, namely a year and a half. So you got a year and a half to get all the way over here. Okay, and the Lord showed signs of way. He tells to the flood, the ocean, and how he did that, he had the chariots of angels and chariots guide the guys all the way over.
Miracles to get you guys on the side of the earth.
Right.
Because the Lord had an ultimate plan and he had to have the rest of his prophecy to fulfill it also.
Right.
But what this shows right here is Christopher Columbus and the guys that said the earth was flat, correct? So they didn't know if they would sail too far this way, if they would fall off the cliff or that way. But when they seen this right here, this guy came looking for you guys because the Bible said this right here. I'm going to prove it to you.
Oh, I got it right here.
You got that? Okay, I got something else too. I think. Go ahead and read what you got.
I got it right here. It says a striking element in Columbus' geographical religiosity.
Yeah, go ahead and bring it up. Off the internet, it's called The First Voyage of Christopher Columbus, 1492, right? So it says, Columbus explored five islands in the modern-day Bahamas before he made it to Cuba. He reached Cuba on October 28th, making landfall at Barai, a harbor near the eastern tip of the island. He says, thinking he had found China, he sent two men to investigate. They were Rodrigo de Jerez and Luis de Torres, a converted Jew who spoke Hebrew, Arabic, in addition to Spanish. Columbus had brought him as an interpreter. So he brought this dude with him on this voyage as an interpreter. You see all the languages that the dude spoke, right? Now watch this. So the dude's name is Luis de Torres, so I print something up on him. It says, because he was versed in Hebrew, Aramaic, Spanish, Portuguese, French, Latin, and some Arabic, Columbus had thought he would be helpful upon their arrival. Especially useful would be his knowledge of Hebrew and Aramaic, as Columbus fully expected to encounter Asian descendants of the lost tribes of Israel. Now they're going to say Asian to throw everybody off. But we just read in the Bible how it said that you guys want to get over here. So Christopher Columbus saw that. He brought Hebrew interpreters with him because he was going to go looking for these people over here. They did a movie on it. It's called The Conquest of Paradise, 1492. He didn't speak Chinese. He didn't speak Chinese, but he spoke Hebrew. See that line? You know, this is how I call these motherfuckers from mine. But this shows you that this white man knows without a shadow of a doubt how true this Bible is. You know what I'm saying? And he studies it. He combs it day and night. He has scholars combing it day and night, trying to find a loophole to get out of what God said he's going to do to him. You know what I'm saying? For real.
Hey, you know what? And add to the point, there's another part I want to read to you. This is out of the Lost Tribe of Promised Lands. It actually tells you about the Mexicans being Israelites. It also tells you about Native Americans, the Seminole Indians, and the Puerto Rican. Puerto Ricans and Cubans being Israelites as well. Now I'm going to show you something in this passage going along to what he said. This is page 79. But meanwhile, the Apocryphal Esdras, which was, by the way, a book of special importance to many Christians, new Christians, has a good deal to say about the original Lost Tribes. This could not have passed lightly under Columbus's somewhat mystical gaze. Surely he saw a special meaning for his own times and for himself in this passage in Second Ezra, the 13th chapter. So what we read to you, he used that to come over here to infiltrate y'all.
Man, if you were on another side of the world, you thought the earth was flat, you read a book that said somebody was over there, so you went looking for them, and those people were over there, you know what that would do for your mind? You would know that this book is real for the rest of life. But yeah, where are you at, man?
Hi, man. My name's Javier, man. Nice to meet you.
What's your name?
Javier.
Your time.
Your time.
Your
name's Gab.
Yeah, all right, nice to meet
y'all. Nice to meet you, man.
Yeah, no problem, man.
What's that?
Oh, no, he's here. He's here.